parts of flower. So in parts of flower, we indicated that I am also explained before to you. So swollen tip of the pedicel is known as the thalamus. Okay, so at the centrally it is at the gynecium part. These are the stamens. After that, corolla. So this is known as that calyx. So it is that bract. These are that bracteoles. Okay, in the parts of flower, it is known as that bract. So these are that bracteoles. Whorl of sepal, that is known as that calyx. Whorl of sepals. Next, corolla. Whorl of petals. Next one, andrisium. Whorl of stamens. Whorl of stamens. After that, gynecium. So it is whorl of carpels, right? So it is a parts of flower. First indicated that bract means it is a, for example, it is a stem or branch. So at the tip of that, so flower having stalk like structure. So flower having stalk like structure, so that is known as a pedicel. Okay, pedicel means a stalk of flower. Stalk of flower is known as that pedicel. Stalk of flower is known as that pedicel, right? So below that pedicel, it means a small leaf like structure is present, that is known as bract. So always flowers are formed from the axil of the bract. After that, small again leaf like structure are present on the pedicel, they are known as the bracteoles. If flowers having bract, so they are known as that bracteate flower. Bracteate flower. If flower having bracteoles, 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 so they are known as a bracteolate flower. Bracteolate flower. After that, flower is okay, so arranged on the thalamus, tip of that tip of pedicel. So it is a pedicel. At that swollen tip of the pedicel is known as the thalamus. That is known as the thalamus. This thalamus is also known as a receptacle. On the thalamus are receptacle, so floral leaves are arranged, four whorls. So it is the first whorl is the calyx, whorl of sepals, corolla is the whorl of petals, whorl of stamen is the third. So whorl of carpels or pistil is known as that gynecium part. Totally, first whorl is known as the calyx, second whorl is the corolla, third one is the andrisium, fourth one is the gynecium part. Okay, so in this, so we discuss about that first one is the calyx. Calyx means what is the meaning? It is the whorl of sepals. Whorl of sepals is known as that calyx. It is outer whorl of that flower. If this calyx, these sepals are appear generally green in color. Green in color. If sepals are free condition, sepals are free condition, So that is known as polycephalus. If sepals are physical condition, so that is known as gamocephalus. Gamocephalus. Polycephalus. So this polycephalus, so example, most of that plants is that some plants are the anona. Anona is as the polycephalus condition, gamocephalus. So gamocephalus means datura. Right? So after then hibiscus, china rose. So these are that gamocephalus example. Right? So generally calyx is okay. What is the use of calyx? So calyx provide protection to that flower. When the flower is present egg condition, so this flower is protected by that. So outer layer is known as that calyx. But in some plants, calyx is okay. After okay. So after fertilization, generally calyx is falls off. But in some plants, calyx is persistent. Persistent means permanent calyx. Permanent calyx. After fertilization, generally calyx is means sepals are falls off. But in some plants, calyx is persistent or permanent. So that is known as persistent calyx. In persistent calyx, for example, you take that solanum tuberosum, brinjal. Solanum tuberosum and rose. Solanum tuberosum means brinjal. In that one, so for example, calyx is attached to that fruit. So it is a fruit. So that is known as permanent calyx. It is attached to that fruit, right? So after fertilization, that is known as persistent calyx. In some plants, calyx is a hair-like structure. Calyx is bunch of hair. Okay? So this calyx is bunch of hair is known as a papus. Okay? For example, in Asteraceae family, in sunflower, so these are the small florets. Outside that, okay, florets, bunch of hair like structure is present. So that is known as that calyx. It is that persistent calyx. This persistent calyx is known as that papus. It is objective bit important. Okay, so it is that generally green in color, but in some plants calyx is bunch of hair. So that is known as papus. So it is present in sunflower. It means belongs to that okay, Asteraceae family. In all Asteraceae family, flowers showing of that papus type of calyx. Okay, so that is known as the calyx is the completed. After that calyx, second one is that corolla. Corolla. Corolla means it is a whorl of petals. Whorl of petals is known as that okay, corolla. Generally corolla, it is appear different color, so bright in color, so this is a corolla. So this corolla is appear different color. Okay, in some plants this corolla or whorl of petals are large size, and in some plants flowers are small. Okay, so what is the use of corolla? Corolla attracted to that insects. It means they are so indirectly participate in cross pollination. It is indirectly participate in cross pollination. It is that objective bit. Generally calyx and corolla, so it is that calyx, it is a corolla, both are not participate in okay reproduction process. That's why calyx and corolla is non-essential organs. Corolla, non-essential organs. Non-essential organs. But, so corolla is attracted to that, okay? So, to that insects involved in the cross-pollination indirectly. It is that objective bit. So, corolla having that different shape. For example, you take that datura, it is objective bits, all are So funnel shape. Next one, disc florets. In sunflower, tubular shape. Next, wheel or bell shape. Okay, so wheel shape generally is a solanum, brinjal, and bell shape, so it means a watermelon or cucumis, cucumber. So after that, some, for example, in salvia, osimum and salvia having that bilipid corolla. Bilipid corolla. So these are that shapes of corolla, right? Shapes of corolla. So it is an object with Dhatura funnel shape, disc florets. Okay, in sunflower, middle flowers are known as the disc florets. So they are tubular shape. So wheel shape brinjal and bell shape in that cucumber. Okay. So after then, in osimum and salvia belongs to Lamiaceae family. They showing of that bilipid corolla. Okay, so that is known as that corolla.